What about you? Welcome to Premier Lawns video. If you're planning your first lawn renovation this year, this video will help you decide on the best way to do it. So stick around. Before we start, if you want to get more out of your lawn this year, hit the subscribe button for more videos like this. And make sure that you smash that like button. This is the channel where we teach you to use tips and tricks from professional lawn care that can be applied to improve your lawn today. If you have any questions about the stuff I'm covering, please leave me a comment. We often get asked on this channel why we aerate and then scarify. We use professional grade tools that can cope if the grass is a bit longer than it should be and it will still rip through the lawns that we do. Now, if I was doing a job like this with a domestic scarifier, something that you would pick up on a garden centre or online, I wouldn't recommend doing it in the order we do it. You're always best setting the scarifier to a higher height and going over the lawn once and then raking a bit off and having a look and seeing how much thatch you've pulled out of the lawn. If you go in deep at the start, you might cause damage that takes a long time to recover. Always do a test patch, scarify an area, rake a bit off, see how much come out, see how much more needs to come out. If you go in deep right at the very start, again, you can cause that long-term damage. For this lawn here, we want to be a bit harder, so we're gonna give it another scarify. We usually do double scarifies, but depending on your own scarifier, you may want to do more. I have a video on how to scarify your lawn step by step. I'll put it on at the end of this video, so make sure you check that out if you want to really dive deep down and learn how to scarify your lawn properly. Number one reason we aerate first is it's much easier to see where it's been aerated before the scarifier goes over the lawn, and this keeps a tight pattern in the lawn, meaning more holes and no missed areas. If this is the first time you're renovating your lawn, chances are you will do these tasks on different days. I recommend carrying out the scarifying on the first day and the aeration on the second day with cleanups in between. Your first job is to mow the lawn, not too short though. It's a beginner mistake to shave the lawn away down to nothing before scarification. This only puts the lawn under stress and will slow the recovery times. Little and often is key to good lawn care. Now, unfortunately, the lawn wasn't cut before our visit. We arrived at the start of the year and unfortunately we were here before the gardener. If you're enjoying this video, if you could give it a big thumbs up, just go ahead and smash that button down there and subscribe for more videos like this and taking your lawn to the next level. The slowest part of any lawn renovation is always tidying up the debris afterwards. If you can do it on a dry day or a windy day, you'll definitely do it a lot faster than on a damp day. I know that's quite obvious, but I thought I'd point it out. feeding your lawn, what's best? There's a lot of fertilizers on the market and it can be very confusing on what to buy. I recommend buying a fertilizer that doesn't contain weed or moss control and applying these two elements separately. This will give you much more control on your lawn. If you're carrying out a spring lawn renovation, then buy a spring lawn fertilizer. And if you're carrying out an autumn lawn renovation, buy an autumn fertilizer. If you follow this, you'll find that brands are less important and over time will give you a lot more choice as you get into lawn care. The last step of a lawn renovation is to treat the moss. Now, if you want to learn why we do it afterwards, make sure you check out the next video.